Hey guys, it's Georgia. So recently I went on a bit of a makeup shopping spree and I bought a few things, so I thought I'd do a haul for them to show you guys what I got. I thought I'd show you guys in case you want to see a certain product that I've purchased in a video to like see how it's used or something like that. If that is the case, then just let me know down below in the comments what product it is and I can definitely do that for you. Also, before we get started, if you aren't already, don't forget to subscribe. You can either click the button on the screen or the one down below in the description. And also, if you want to check out my Instagram, it's at GeorgiaKK. Feel free to go follow it. And I'll also leave that down below in the description in case you want to check it out. Without further ado, let's get started. So I'm pretty sure every time I went into a different store, my wallet had like a little cry to itself. So first off, I went to Sephora and I only got one thing from there, which is this Zoeva Soft Paint Liner Brush. And you can't really see it in the box. Basically, it's just an eyeliner brush and it's got an angled tip and I'm trying to open it, but it can't. There we go. So it's an eyeliner brush and it's got an angled tip for doing winged eyeliner. That is what it looks like. I've not actually used a Zoeva brush before. I've only ever used Sigma. But Sigma in Australia, you have to pay a crap load for shipping. So it's good that Zoeva's here and it's just the price of the brush, not including like shipping. That is what I got from Sephora. By the way guys, Sephora's heaps different in Australia than it is in America because a lot of the brands are split between Mecca and Sephora, so I actually got more from Mecca, which are the same brands that you'd find overseas in Sephora, but they've been like split between the two. So from Sephora I got quite a few things. I bought another veil primer because I was running out and I freaked out because I thought I brought the wrong one because the packaging is different, but it turns out this is just like a bigger size than the one I've got. But like, I nearly had a heart attack because these things aren't cheap. And I thought I'd bought the wrong one, so. I actually really like this packaging. It's very nice, very sleek. I got quite a few things from Hourglass. No, from Hourglass. So I also got this eyebrow pencil. That was a really long pause on that pen pop. So this is their Arch Eyebrow Sculpting Pencil. It's really cool because it's got a triangle tip to it. So it makes it easier to like get really fine parts and then the thicker part to fill them in and stuff. So it's just really good because you can switch between the two sides depending on what part of your eyebrow you're doing. And then it comes with this little spoolie thing on the end, and Hourglass, your eyebrow pencil is just freaking amazing. I can appreciate a good eyebrow brush. Oh, by the way, I'm doing stuff from Mecca. Yeah, just so you know. Ooh. Okay, so now I've got a lipstick which is also from Hourglass. And this is their satin finish one in Femme Nude number 6. Yeah, nude number 6. And their Femme Nude lipstick. That was really bad explaining, but yeah. Anyway, all the products will be down below in the description if my explaining has confused you, because it's confusing me and I'm the one talking. Anyway, this is a lipstick. It's got a really cool tip because it's like a pencil. Oh my god, I keep like pausing on my pen parts. So it's a wind-up bottom, which means... Oh, all lipsticks are wind up, aren't they? Oh yeah, all lipsticks are wind up, but it's got like a switch at the bottom that you wind and it comes out and it's just a really gorgeous color. I'll swatch it on my hand. It's a really gorgeous mauvey nude color and it's just perfect for every day because it's not too pink, but it's not too purple. It's just like that perfect in between. Next up, I got a lipstick from Stila and this is their Stay Your Day liquid lipstick in Patina. So in the tube, it looks like it's a pinky color, but when you take it out, it's a really purpley pink. It's a really purpley color and it's not coming up on camera the same as it does in real life, but it's really purpley and pink. And when it does say, when it says stay all day, it seriously does, because I went and tried on other lipsticks after it and that probably wasn't the best lipstick to have on my lips when I'm going to be taking it off again in a couple of hours. So yeah, it seriously does stay all day. I've got some video ideas of using this lip color in them. I like threw it then. That was a weird laugh, oh my god. But I'm super excited to have this because I've got a few video ideas of this lip color that it could be used in. And yeah, stay tuned for that. So I also got some stuff from Smashbox and it's the Smashbox Step-by-Step Contour Stick Trio. So basically it is three sticks that look like pencils. And So you've got a bronzer one, a contour one, and a highlight one. So the bronze is a like warmer toned one, and then the contour stick is a really cool toned brown, while the highlight is a whitish yellowy color. Like, they're just perfect because all the contouring and bronzing needs are right in these three pencils. Plus it comes with a sharpener, which is really good because these are really like thick pencils and it's hard to get sharpeners that suit such thick like pencils. So that is really good. Smashbox, you're onto it. So that is all I got from Mecca, and then I also paid a visit to MAC. I've been wanting to get the color Velvet Teddy in their lipsticks for a while. So that is what I picked up. It's this really gorgeous color. So obviously it looks like a MAC lipstick. So it's another nude and it's more red based than the other nudes. It's coming out different on my hand. It's just really gorgeous. And then to go with that lipstick, I got a lip liner, and this is Boldly Bare. And it's just a red based lip liner. So yeah, that's what I got from MAC. So this next product is one I've been wanting for ages, and I've been saving up to get it, and it's this Chanel Soleil Tan de Chanel. So it's a bronzing makeup base, and it can be used as a primer, but it works really well as a bronzer. This is what the packaging looks like. Oh my god, it just... Okay, so this is what it looks like, and it looks like that. Oh my god, it just looks so good. I don't even want to use it. I will though, because obviously... No, it doesn't have a smell. I don't know why I have like a halo going on. I think it's because the sun's setting. But anyway, so I've been wanting to get this for ages, and I want to use it as a bronzer. Probably see me using this in a couple of my videos. And to be honest, it's not that expensive considering it's Chanel. It's honestly pretty much the same price as any other high-end brand like NARS. So yeah, I'm super excited. I hope you guys enjoyed this haul, and once again, if there's any products that you saw in this video that you really want to see in a future video of how to use them or just in a makeup look or something, then let me know down below in the comments and I can most certainly do that for you. If you aren't already, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the subscribe button. You can either click the one on the screen or the one down below in the description. And also don't forget to check out my Instagram, which is at GeorgiaKK. I'll also leave that down below in the description if you're wanting to check that out. Well, that is all for today's video, and I'll see you guys in next week's. Bye, lovelies. I try my best to pretend that I'm not home, because I think you're better to forget. And then I hear the rocks against my window.